call meeting, and we will get directly into our business for this meeting.
5 o'clock.
At least we know we're punctual.
Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. First attachment you have is information from Judge Waylon Sermon. I think everybody had the opportunity to look at the different statutes. I don't think anybody have any questions or concerns regarding that. So let's move on to the letters from agencies regarding the June 6th and June 8th jail issues. Any questions or concerns with those? Okay, let's move to the report then. Captain Christina, or is that manager?
I'll cover this to give you an overview. You talk about number two or number three?
Number three.
Okay. Number three is the report from Watson Electric Company. We've been working with them over the past week and a half. Our students done a very good job, thorough job of assembling the folks that we needed, the electrical contractors, electrical engineers, the state jail inspector, the building inspector, the fire marshal, and working also with the sheriff's department and all the staff there to determine the cause of the problems. And a lot has been accomplished. The problems have been diagnosed, but we still have a little bit of work to do that remains to get the total problem solved so we can get the inmates back in and use the facility again. Pretty much it's been narrowed down to the a dryer that we put in, the defective wiring in the dryer that we discovered, and that's been agreed to by several of the experts. So we feel good that was the cause of the issue, but there's some other things that we're working on to get repaired. There's been a whole lot of analysis and work done in the past week and a half by Christina and the other folks that I mentioned. So I think that we're just going to need a couple more days. It's probably less than 2 weeks. I would say that it's probably at least a week to get the remaining work done, repairs done, so that we can have the facility operational.
Okay. Any questions or comments from any commissioners? Okay, number four, we do not need. Number five, the cease and desist notice from Judge Pollard.
Well, that's a different matter that we've been dealing with in recent months related to the energy saving generator that was added outside the courthouse last year. I guess it was last summer when that was made operational. Well, maybe it's been actually the summer before that. There's been off and on problems with it from the beginning. The generator is extremely noisy when it operates. It was placed next to the building there, and it interferes with the staff inside the building being able to do their work due to the noise and the conduct of meetings and when court is going on. And that's the reason for that direction from Judge Paul, is just to make sure that we proceed with addressing that problem. We have already met with contacted the company that operates that generator, and they will no longer operate it during the period from April 5, Monday through Friday. It will only operate after 5 p.m. in the evenings and on weekends. So I think that problem has been solved. So the only time it will come on now would be if the total power is lost from the outside of that building. It will come on to keep the building operational, which is all glorious and all. Which, as it came on earlier this year, when we had a power outage in the county, and the courthouse was fully operational in all the different agencies. So I think we're waiting to hear back from Judge Paul. I've notified him about how we hope to have addressed that issue and make sure it's acceptable solution with him, And he's out of town, I believe, for a judge's conference this week, and he gets back, I'll get with him early next week, hopefully, or end of this week, he gets back then, and make sure that we're okay with him.
Okay, any questions or comments from any commissioners on that item? Okay, we'll move forward to the generator information update and presentation on the status of the jail.
Call on Ms. Smith now to just give us a brief overview of her findings and her recommendation.
I believe Mr. Woodruff copied issued you on an email that I sent to him yesterday evening, and that's basically the findings that we found. The power outage on Thursday, June 6th, as well as Saturday evening, June 8th. As we said earlier, we isolated that to wiring issues specifically in the dryer. The dryer has now been disconnected from the other building system, and there are still a few issues that still need to be addressed, I believe, and those are outlined in the email as well. Electrical engineer has come back in again yesterday and did an additional walkthrough, and they're going back to consulting to come up with potential solutions for us in the future. Once again, what Mr. Woodruff referenced, that we're looking at possibly a week to 2 weeks to do that.
Do you have any other information for us?
Well, I think it's really important to point out that everyone involved in this situation has worked very closely together. We've got in close contact with the sheriff, the resident superior court judge. We've met several times with him to try to work together to resolve these issues and address the problems. The sheriff's staff is going through an enormously difficult time now, having to do all these transports with our inmates, taking them back and forth to three different facilities outside the county. And the work's only going to get more difficult next week when the court goes back into session. So that's the goal. We're working as fast as we can to get it resolved, and hopefully next week, we'll do it next week if we can, but it may take another week. It's just going to depend on if we can get the parts and things that are needed. If they are available, they're in stock somewhere, we can get our hands on them, and the contractors can get the work done.
Well, I understand.
Ms. Smith, do you have anything else to add about that?
Respond to any questions, commissioners?
Any commissioners with any questions? Thank you. Our next item is the cost of inmate relocation.
You have a handout regarding this matter, and this is the result of going, I guess, about 10 days without being able to house inmates here in the county, and it's just extremely expensive. We've spent approximately a little less than $40,000 at this point, and I asked Jim to do this memo. He worked it up this morning, so it gives you a good detailed overview of the cost. The average daily cost is $52, and we've got about 70 inmates in our custody now that have been phoned out to these various facilities. And you see that's been on your travel cost, the estimated daily cost of $3,600. And of course, there are unknown costs probably at this time that we haven't included in this, so this is just a tentative figure. It will go up more, and of course, the longer we are in this situation, it's gonna add up significantly. So that's why, obviously, we are working to get the situation resolved as quick as possible. Next week, when courts are going again, it's gonna, just like I just mentioned, it's gonna be extremely difficult for the sheriff's staff to make all this work, and the calls are gonna be, they're gonna be on the road constantly, going one way or the other. So I think that's why we're working as hard as we can. I think it's a challenging situation. Anytime you're working with a building that is, not that our building is ancient, but it's certainly not a brand new building. So that when you're working with that type of facility, there's unexpected things that come up that you have to deal with, and you have difficulties finding parts and replacement issues and things, and that's what we're dealing with. But I think overall, it's gone well. Christina has done an excellent job. She's been involved, fully engaged with this every day, all on weekends, nighttime, around the clock. So I think we've been lucky to have her during this situation. Never a good situation to be in, but I think we've been able to endure the best we can. So any other questions or comments y'all have?
Any other questions or any commissioners? The next thing says a discussion, and the only thing I think that really needs to be discussed, I think, is just a point of clarification. For some strange reason, it seems that everybody's under the opinion that we are moving backwards instead of moving forward as far as a jail is concerned. Now, unless I'm sadly mistaken, and all these commissioners can pretty much speak for themselves, I don't think we are at a point where we've decided that we do not need a new jail. I think the point where we were was a matter of as to where the new jail would be located. Now, if things have changed from that particular time to now, I mean, let's talk about that right now and then we continue to move forward. But I don't think anybody has changed from that.
Well, there's just one thing. The amount of money we're spending daily not to have prisoners in that jail in the real world of math. Whatever we're spending to a day, we're moving that much further away each day away from getting a new jail. I tell you that.
Okay, so it appears that we are still on track into working toward a new facility. Any other questions, comments, or concerns? Just the handout was FYI. That's all right.
Okay. I will motion to adjourn in order.
Yes, sir.
Motion to adjourn.
Have a motion there, a second.
Second.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, we'll adjourn.